Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the 15th meeting of the Rural Affairs, Islands and Natural Environment Committee in Session 6. Before we begin, can I remind committee members using electronic devices to switch them to silence. Our first item of business this morning was to be consideration of two notifications from Scottish Ministers for consent to two UKSIs. The Cabinet Secretary has written to the committee, however, to confirm that the Scottish Government has withdrawn the notification for the Officials Controls Extension of Transitional Period Amendment No. 2 Regulation 2021, as it now intends to make provision via Scottish SI. The Clerk circulated the letter to members on receipt. Members will note that the SSI will need to have come into effect by the 1st of January. Do members have any comments on the withdrawal of the SI? Okay, that means that we only have one notification to consider today, the approved countries list animals and animal products amendment number 2 regulation 2021, and refer members to papers 1 and 2 pages 3 to 14 in our paper packs. Under the protocol between the Scottish Parliament and the Scottish Government, this consent notification has been categorised as type 1, meaning the Scottish Parliament's agreement is sought before the Scottish Government gives consent to the UK Government laying the instruments. First, members will note that the Clerk sought further information from the officials in advance of today's meeting, and this information has been circulated to members. Second, in responding to the Scottish Government, and as set out in paragraphs 31 on page 12, I suggest that the committee ask the Scottish Government to clarify whether the trade agreements with Ukraine and Australia specify a time frame in which changes to import restrictions must be made. And third, the Scottish Parliament has not been given the full 28-day scrutiny period to consider this notification, and the Scottish Government claims that SI must be made quickly in order not to impact the UK's trade relations with Australia and the Ukraine. The notification does not, however, make it clear how a delay of a few days to allow the appropriate parliamentary scrutiny of the regulations would negatively impact on trade relations. And I would like to put on record my strong concerns around the lack of time available for meaningful parliamentary scrutiny in relation to this instrument. On this occasion, the terms of the protocol have not been met. Does any member have any comments on the consent notification for this SI? Rachel Hamilton.
My microphone is unmuted there. Okay, I haven't done this in a long time, convener. Exactly echoing what you have just said there, but I think I missed the date that this will come into effect. Was it the 1st of January as well?
Goodness. Maybe ask Emma if she's got the date of when it actually comes into play. Let me just...
The reason being is because, clearly, for the reasons that you have stated, is that this committee will not have opportunity to scrutinise the particular impact that that may have. And so I'd just like some clarity on that, if I may, please, convener.
Okay, we can check that out. The notification was sent to the Scottish Parliament on the 7th of December, with the intended laying date in Westminster of the 16th of December. And the Scottish Parliament has therefore been given less than 28 days. So the date of laying it in Westminster would be the 16th of December, which is tomorrow. But we can clarify that with you, Rachel. Alistair Allen. Is Alistair still with us? We may have lost Alistair.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead, Alistair.
Apologies, for complicated reasons I'm in my car today. To ask in that case, I didn't quite catch everything you said there, but did you say that the SI is only laid tomorrow in the UK Parliament, and has the UK government offered an explanation for the timing of that?
The notification was sent to the Scottish Parliament on the 7th of December. We would be given less than 28 days. So, yes, absolutely. That's you know, we haven't had that in time, and we're not quite sure why there's the urgency, and that's why we're asking for clarification about how an extension of a few days to allow us to have the full 28 days, you know, why that couldn't be considered. We just want to know what the impact would be. The UK government.
My question is really whether. Well, I suppose my question is really about the reasons for the UK government's timing.
Yes, that's right, and we will. That's what we want the clarification over, is why the delay is going to negatively impact the trade relations. So we need to have that clarified.
Okay.
Okay. Any other members wish to comment? Karen?
Fairly here. Can you hear me okay?
Jim, could you put an R in the chat box?
Right. Okay, my apologies.
Karen?
I see Karen's got an R in the chat box.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Convener. I was just going to ask, what draft are we looking at here of the SI? Is this the... What version of the SI are we looking at in terms of draft?
Okay, this is... This is the, if you look at page 7, it gives you the details there. So this is the SI that's been laid. Yeah, this is the final draft, if you like.
It is the final draft.
Yeah. This is about approving the notification and paper 2.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Jim Fairley.
Yeah, thanks, Convener. So let me just clarify. We were asking the Scottish Government why we didn't have enough time to scrutinise the SI, but it's in fact a UK Government issue, not a Scottish Government issue. Is that correct?
Well, that might be the case, but what the Scottish Government has to do is ask the Scottish Parliament for approval. So we will write to the Scottish Government to ask why there was the delay and we were given less than 28 days. Yes.
But have you not just told Alistair that it's the UK government that haven't stated the full SI in the first place?
But it's not the role of this committee to scrutinise the UK government's position. It's for us to ask the Scottish government why it's the case. Now, they may say it's because they didn't get it in time, and that's fine. Right. But it's our position is to approve the Scottish government's given consent.
Right, okay. So we're asking the Scottish Government to clarify that the UK Government didn't actually have the SI in front of them in time.
Yes.
Okay, that's fine. Thank you, Alistair. Thanks, Finlay.
Okay. Any further comments? No. Okay, yes. Is the committee... Alistair.
Hi. I just want to pick up on what's been said there. I mean, I understand the point that's being made about the process of an SI. However, I would disagree with the idea that it's not this committee's role to ask any questions about timing of the UK government. And I don't want to leave the impression hanging there that the UK government's role in this is irrelevant. So I think it is entirely relevant if we're going to ask questions about timing of the Scottish government, given what's just been said, that we do write to the UK government and ask them the question.
I'll ask Emma to come in. As my understanding is that we need to write to the Scottish government to clarify why there was the urgency, and they will be able to tell us, given the instrument was sent to the Scottish Parliament.
There's no ban on the committee writing to the UK government to ask questions.
No, absolutely not. But it's the Scottish government that lays the tool in front of us to ask us if we are content that they've give consent to the UK instrument. So you know, we will. This is the point. We will write to the Scottish government to ask why there was urgency. because the Scottish Government could.
I'm just proposing that we ask a question, and I'm not sure what the problem is with asking the question.
Yeah, well, we certainly can. If it would help, we can also write to the UK Government the same question. But ultimately, it is the Scottish Government that have laid this for us to give consent, for them to consent to the UK instrument. That's my understanding. But we can certainly, we can write to the UK Government if that would help. Jim Fairley and then Rachel Hamilton.
Yeah, thanks, Finlay. Just to be clear, the Scottish Government are laying an SI in this committee on the basis of, the Scottish Government are asking us to agree to an SI that has been laid by this committee, which should have come from the UK Government. The UK Government haven't given us the appropriate period of time. And from the letter that the convener that we got from the clerks this morning, say that the UK Government have suddenly changed importation rules without any consultation from the Scottish Government.
No, Jim, that's a different SI. You're talking about a different SI.
That a different SI? Right, OK. Thank you very much for the clarity. But I have to say, I do echo Alistair's point. If the UK Government haven't got it in time, how is it the responsibility of the Scottish Government?
Well, that's what we're seeking clarity on. The notification was sent to the Scottish Parliament on the 7th of December. That
was
doesn't
that
mean
was that the final one?
This is the SI that's in front of us. It was sent to the Scottish Parliament on the 7th of December with the intent of it being laid in Westminster on the 16th of December. We can write to the Scottish Government and ask why the Parliament was only notified of this on the 7th of December. It's unclear to me at the moment when the Scottish Government got that SI from the UK Government. That's my understanding.
Right, OK, because I thought you said that they didn't get it in time to do the 20-day. OK, we clearly need clarity, and I think Alistair's point stands that we should be writing to the UK Government as well.
Yeah, I absolutely appreciate that's not a problem, but what's unclear at the moment is when the Scottish Government got the notification. What I'm trying to say is the Scottish Parliament, that's us and the committee, only got the notification on the 7th of December, so we can ask for clarification on when the Scottish Government got the notification. Does that make it clearer?
Yes, it does. But I still think there is a responsibility to the UK Government, and I think we need to be writing to the UK Government as well.
Yeah, but it's unclear whether the UK Government were late in sending the notification, and that date I don't have.
Okay.
Rachel Hamilton.
Thanks, Convener. I think this is proving why it's so much better to have a physical meeting rather than virtual. But anyway, on the point that we're making here, can I just ask about the point that's made on number 23, which says that the Scottish and the UK government argue that it must come into force as soon as possible. Because if there's shared interest here, I'm right in saying there's a shared objective here, there just seems to be some sort of other reason for a delay.
My understanding is that we don't know why this protocol is urgent. We don't know why we haven't been given the full 28 days. So I intend to write the Scottish Government asking why it's an urgent SI and why an extra few days, which would allow us to scrutinise this properly, hasn't been given. As I say, it's unclear when the Scottish Government received the policy proposal in the form of the instrument in time, and it's the Scottish Government that notified the Scottish Parliament late. So that's what we need to clarify. But again, yes, absolutely. In the letter, I will ask why it is urgent and what impact on trade relations an extra few days would make.
Thank you.
Okay, Alistair Allen.
Thank you. Just on the point Rachel's made there, and I can heartily agree that it would be better if we were meeting offline rather than online, rather than me sitting in my car here. But I have to say there are good reasons why, you know, there are certain constraints on us in the moment, and I think that you know, it's worth not overlooking that. The other thing I would say is that I think this is a reasonable course of action, but I think we should just be clear what it is we're trying to find out here. And I think presumably what we're trying to find out is when the final version of the SI was made available to the Scottish Government, because, you know, we're not interested in when drafts were available.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm not aware, and it doesn't really you know, affect this committee. The whole point is that we have not been given the 28 days as required by the SI protocol to scrutinise this. But the letter will ask why that's the case, and we'll ask when the Scottish Government were notified of this SI. And they may come back that they say that they got it late from the UK Government, and that's you know, that's possibly what happened. Or there may be a reason why the Scottish Government didn't lay it. That's, I'm not giving a judgment, I don't know, but we'll certainly ask the questions as to why we're, why this has arisen. It's not the first time, and we don't want it to become a habit forming, if you like. Okay, can I just ask Emma, our clerk, whether you know, the questions have been asked are and my responses are, you know, in line with the papers, that we don't actually know when the Scottish Government received the UK statutory instrument. Emma. Emma.
Thank you very much, Convener. So my understanding is that the Scottish Government was contacted at short notice, and that the notification was drafted at short notice. Officials contacted the clerks informally to give us warning that the notification would be received. And as the notification states, the UK Government and the Scottish Government were agreed that the short timescale was required in order to not to negatively impact trade relations.
Okay. I hope that provides some clarity. But we, as I say, one of the questions we're going to ask is why, because it's not clear whether those trade deals specify a time frame. So we don't know what the pressure is on having to bring it in at such short notice. Okay. Any further questions, comments? Okay. Is the committee content that the provisions set out in the notification should be included in the proposed UK SI? If you're not satisfied, if you could type an N in the chat function. Okay, we're content. Finally, is the committee content to delegate authority to me, sign off a letter to the Scottish Government informing a decision today? And I do intend to set out strong concerns around the lack of available time for meaningful scrutiny and the breach of the protocol in my letter. And also copy in the letter to the convener of the Constitution, Europe, External Affairs and Culture Committee for our information. I will also highlight concerns in that letter relating to the withdrawn SI. Okay. Alistair.
Just so that you're speaking on behalf of all of us, can you just summarise what your concerns are about the withdrawn SI and why it's a concern that you think the committee as a whole shares?
It was the concerns were around the fact that we had it in front of us and it's been withdrawn at a very late stage, and asked for the reasons for that. We did have a letter outlining some of the reasons, and it will be laid in front of us. But once again, we are not going to get a chance to look at that because it needs to come into force on the 1st of January.
Well, I suppose my point is, I mean, it's a fair point to, you know, draw attention to that, you know, less than ideal circumstance. But I mean, we have just had a letter this morning from the Scottish Government, you know, that gives reasons in its view why a Scottish SI is necessary. given the changes that have been made in the last few days to the UK ESI at rapid pace by the UK government. So I suppose I'm just really looking for some assurance that the tone of the letter that's written will reflect that.
The reason for the letter is, once again, only to suggest that the committee is concerned that we're going to have no opportunity to look at the proposed SI before it's laid on the 1st of January.
That's fine. If that's the tone, I'm happy with that. But you know, my point is made that we have. I think we should acknowledge the fact that we have had, you know, correspondence, albeit just this morning, from the Scottish Government that does set out some of their reasons.
Yes. Yep. I absolutely take that on board. Thank you. Okay. That concludes our public business for today, and we now move into private session on Microsoft Teams. And members will find the link in the calendar request for today's meeting. Close this meeting.